Absolutely. I love talking about JoJo's. One of my favorite things. I will talk to JoJo's or anybody who is willing to listen and just enjoy JoJo time with me.
Welcome to Doster. I'm Mizumi.
Do you know Japanese graphic novel called JoJo's Bizarre Adventure? In Japanese, JoJo no Kimyo na Bouken. We call JoJo. JoJo is known for... If you don't know,
shame on you.
Anyway, I met an American JoJo lover, and her knowledge of JoJo is amazing.
Doster.
We're going to show your friend how amazing JoJo is. An absolute legend named Hirohiko Araki drew all this beautiful art that you see before you. For the past 32 years, he has gifted the world with the greatest story ever told 8 times. We have Jonathan Joestar, who's British. He's from like the 19th century, like 1800s. And his grandson, Joseph Joestar. And then his grandson, Jotaro Kujo. And then his uncle, who is 16. Jotaro's uncle, Joseph's illegitimate son, Josuke. And then we have, this is a tricky one. This is the guy from Italy. This is Giorno Giovanna. He's from part 5, he's the Italian. We like him.
Okay.
And then we have Jotaro's daughter, Jolene. She's the only female JoJo so far. And then the universe resets after that. Now we have Cowboy and Johnny Jozar. He fights the President of the United States. It's amazing. And then this is the character I'm supposed to look like. This is Josuke, aka Gappy. Because there's 2 Josuke Higashikata characters from part 4 and part 8, the fandom kind of just calls him Gappy because he has a gap in his teeth. And this is where we are right now. The current part is part 8. It's not finished yet. Stands are like a physical manifestation of like your fighting spirit. It's kind of like almost like a psychic ghost that's like connected to you, and some of them they fight for you. Sometimes they have like special abilities that allow the JoJo characters to have, like, use unique strategies to like get out of bad situations or fight bad guys. So, but usually they just like stand, like that's why they're called stands, because they stand behind the user and fight with them. That makes sense, right? Yeah, that makes sense, right? Yeah, that's like the magic of JoJo's having stands, but there are parts that don't have stands, but they are still very good. You can see, like, this is Jotaro and his stand, Star Platinum. And his ability is that he punches really hard, and then he learns how to stop time. He's a little OP. Jonathan and Joseph didn't really get stands. Their parts just don't have stands because of the earlier part. They had something called Hamon, which was like magic psychic like kung fu fighting. I don't know how to explain it. It's like a breathing technique that allows you to punch really good, I guess. It's kind of weird. They all used it for 2 parts. And we have, oh wait, the sidekicks, the Zeppelis! Okay, these are also the Italians. We really like them too. Within like 3 parts, there are the Zeppelis. And they're the best friend to the JoJo's. This one on the end, this is Gyro. He is the best Zeppeli. He is the most handsome man from the 19th century. This is Jolene. This is her sandstone 3. This is Gappy. This is me. And his stand is called Soft and Wet. And it makes bubbles. Really powerful bubbles. And this is Joseph. And this is Josuke. And Josuke's stand is a shining diamond, a crazy diamond. Oh shit, I forget. Because the localization name always messes me up. Shining diamond. And its ability is like, if something is broken or damaged, he can punch it and it fixes it. He has like healing punching power. He heals through punching. Giorno Giovanna and his stand, Gold Experience, it basically brings life into things that don't have life. Like, he could take a pen and make it into like a butterfly. Like, he could just bring life to things. He's kind of like Jesus, just grants life. Very overpowered, very good. And then there's Johnny and his stand, Tusk. I'm still trying to get through part 7.
Are they all males?
Except for Jolene. Jolene is the only woman. This is Jotaro's daughter. She's the only female JoJo. Don't worry, there are women in the part, like sidekicks and family members and stuff, but Jolene's like the main female. Over the course of like 32 years, Araki's art style has changed, and a lot of that is displayed here. You can see like what a difference like this, between like this, and this, like his art style just like evolves, and it's really cool. How he draws like characters from like part 1 and how they would look if they were in like part 7 or 8. There's a lot of fashion inspiration here. So this right here was done especially for Gucci. This was a Gucci collaboration JoJo did. Yes, you heard that right there. It's a Gucci collab. And I think Araki like designed this dress for her and everything. And there was like a whole like kind of like a side comic, like kind of like a one shot spin-off where it's just like called Fly High with Jolene, and she's like in the airport with all her Gucci swag on, and she meets other JoJos also wearing Gucci, and they like fight about a unicorn. It's kind of weird. But everything in JoJo is very weird. Oh wait, this is my favorite picture. I love this character. His name is Bruno Bucciarati. He's Italian. And he was on the cover of this fashion magazine wearing an outfit that was on the Balenciaga runway. This magazine was published in Japan, but the character is Italian, if that makes sense. Like, he's a JoJo character. But, like, his nationality, the character's nationality is Italian. And he's wearing an outfit that was on the Balenciaga runway. And this is, like, a fashion magazine.
But she doesn't look like Italian.
Oh, this is a man.
But why he got lipsticks?
All the men in JoJo's have lipsticks. Oh, so a lot.
And what about eyelashes?
That's just his art style.
Now all the Italian men are wearing eyelashes.
Oh, just you wait and see.
To be honest, they look like drag queens.
Yeah, they do. I will not argue that. That is a true opinion. They do.
I understand what you are into now.
They're just all just drawn so beautifully, and the stories are just very, very well written. They're in depth. Like, the characters are drawn with a lot of depth. They're created with that. They're written very, very well. Alright, let me show you this really silly avatar I found last night. Really take it in. Bruno Gucciarati. He's got the whole Gucci on. I don't have a mirror in here, so I can't see what I'm doing, but did I take off the hat? But it is the most ridiculous thing I have ever seen. Are you ready for the greatest show of your life? Hold on. Hold on to your hat.
Jeez, I cannot watch it, sorry.
He is just really going for it. He's absolutely stunning.
Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like it, please give us a comment and subscribe our channel. See you in next video!